Entry 9. Once again, I'm getting that claustrophobic feeling as I walk around my property. It's time again to be expanding my facilities. I have the perfect plan for how to add on to my existing stronghold while providing easier access to my tree farm and other facilities. Now it's just a matter of what materials and color scheme to use. I am getting quite tired of the look of cobblestone. Oh, let me get out of my chair here. Hold on. There we go. Hey, everybody. How you doing? Lazerous here. Welcome back to Ascension of the Technomancer. Alrighty. As our journal has stated, we are going to be doing some building today. We're going to have a building episode. I kind of need to, I don't know what to do in terms of progress, really. We don't have a lot of room to expand. And really, I kind of just need to get some episodes recorded here. It's been a while since I've recorded, and I've kind of, you know, I'm falling behind. I don't have a lot more content to put out. Had an unfortunate sort of tragic experience recently. I lost one of my guinea pigs. Cooper passed away a couple days ago. He was very old for a piggy, but still, it's really sad, and, you know, that definitely certainly put a damper on the recording schedule. And I also went out and spent the weekend with some friends, and that was pretty fun. I enjoyed that, but again, not actually recording. I will say one thing cool, though. While I was there, I got to try out the some VR. I got to try out the Vive headset. It's fucking amazing. I gotta say, it's... Wow. I can't even put into words how wow it is. And just think, like, playing Minecraft in VR, that would be amazing. I don't know if, even with, like, a spectacular graphics card, I could get the frame rates required for that, but there's a good chance. Yeah. And it would be pretty amazing. So, I'm thinking... Yeah, I'm kind of jumping all over the place with topics here, but I'm thinking, let's do something with marble. Marble's cool. I'm very partial to marble. It's one of those really easy blocks to use. You know, it just looks good in pretty much any situation. So let's get our chisel here and see what we can do. Now, let me show you the spectacular mess I've made of everything here. Now, there used to be a wall, like right here. Like right here. And we kicked that wall back a bit further. And then we moved this little entry area here, this little, like, hallway thing down a bit. Yeah, I kind of like it like this. Okay. There's room enough here for another coke oven and another blast furnace. That's the point. This is just some scaffolding. This is meaningless. This is just there to fill in the ceiling. This is still the same storage room. As you can see, we got some missing regions here. Like, this wall got kicked further back. Like, the walls for everything kind of just got pushed back. Like, this wall got pushed back, and then the back wall of this room got pulled back. Like, everything just kind of went back about 6 blocks. And there's a reason for that, and I will show you, probably best to show you from outside, but you can kind of see the little hole over there. It's all part of the plan. There is a plan. I have a plan. So let's hop up on here, and as you can see now, there's not really a way through here anymore. I kind of filled that in with dirt, and there's a reason for that too. So this hill is back to like its original size. There's no path around it here. Let's kill Tree Man here. He's a fucker. He doesn't belong here. Get out of here, Tree Man. Wow, like with the sound effect and everything, like I punched him in the face so hard he just fell to bits. There's no easy way back from here. I guess there is. This is the other part of it. You know what? Let's not bust that out right now. I'll show you. Maybe I should have just went in through that way. But now you can kind of see what I'm planning here, though. We've got a corridor coming off the right. Also, we're in a new version of the pack. This is 370. There have been some mob rebalances. Oh, you fucker. Where did you even go? Just like friggin' space jump over here. You fucker. Get out of here. Yeah, so some enemies are more common than they used to be. Direwolves are one of them. So now we have that noise to enjoy all the time. And there's been some changes to progression also for this. This is still in development, but the Aether has been added to this pack. So now if you want to get, say, the airship, get an airship, you got to do the Aether. The Twilight Forest now is used to get an item you need to get into the Advent of Ascension dimension. So before you can start doing AoA stuff, you got to complete the Twilight. It's like your baseline to know that you're strong enough to start trying AoA content. You should at least be able to clear the Twilight without too much difficulty. So, all right, this here, we'll put a floor in too. But like right here, we can knock this out now. Boom, boom. Let's start building a room. We gotta dig this out a little bit here. Yes, this is going to be ground level here, and then we can do a step down. I think somewhere I want to have a stairwell that goes underground and also meets up with the underneath the tree farm. But, you know, that's a later step. And as for what we're going to do with this room, I'm thinking this is we're going to put our assembly table in here. So this is where our laser setup will be. Maybe also do the carpenter, or a carpenter and a thermionic fabricator. The water-based carpenter. You also need a carpenter for making, like, tracks, like railcraft, like rail ties. We'll probably want a separate one for that. So we'll put that in there. And ethanol production. Or not, maybe not ethanol, but biodiesel. I think ethanol is involved in making biodiesel. So we're going to put like a stack of fermenters and distilleries in here as well. And I think that's what we'll put in this room. And then, so this is what's going to be over on the right here. So if we're looking towards the back wall of the room for right now, we have this stuff over on our right. And over on the left, where I flattened out that area, we're going to put a large room for our boiler. That's where our Greg Tech, like, big multi-block boiler is going to live. But that's, you know, that's the next project. Provided we have enough supplies to even do that. So let's break this shit out first, and then we'll see where we're at in terms of space. So, I think we've cut down all the trees. We've cut down a lot of trees, actually. Maybe that's why. That was another thing that happened, is we had like a sort of wintry storm here, and a tree kind of shit on my car and busted up the windshield. Real not thrilled with that. So just lots of events have occurred lately. One of them good, most of them bad. Like, you know, chilling with my buddies from work, that was pretty fun. And I can't say enough about that. If you actually are in a situation where you, like, actually enjoy, like, hanging out and spending time with the people you work with every day, that is just a really amazing situation. And I guess maybe I just want to preserve my appreciation for that video. And just, like, you know, if you guys are watching it right now, you know who you are. And I know some of you are watching this series. Thank you. You know, it really brightens my day to work with you guys. And if anyone else out there is in a situation where you're actually... and you enjoy the company of the, like, of the people you work with, or people that you would choose to spend your free time with, you should be very grateful for that situation. Oh, we're hunting for blood. Okay, nope, 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 nope. Get me in. Okay, well, let's just put this down here, because we don't need any, like, fuckers flying around. That's the most dangerous part about the blood hunt, is there's these flying, like, eyeball things, like one eye and a mouth and a couple of ears, just two, regular quantity of ears. And they shoot at you, and they—I don't think their projectiles do explosive damage, but I don't think they break blocks. Still, though, like they definitely get the drop on you because they just sort of appear in the sky. So this needs to go a lot further back. Let's try to get a look at this and see how far back we want this to go. Hibbit, hibbit, hibbit. Oh, there's like more space over here. Yeah, so maybe we should actually. Make this a fairly big room. Let's, let me think about this here. I know we want to cut it back, I mean, several more blocks, because as you can see, like, this is the hallway right here, so we want to have the room go out here some, maybe to, like, this far, at least this far. Maybe a little further, and then we'll cut it back from here a couple more blocks. And then we'll lay out a little, we'll sort of lay out a one block high outline of what we think the, like, you know, the basic dimensions of the room, and just see how we feel about that, and see if it needs to be bigger. It's going to be a lot of digging in this episode. I should have made a diamond tool. That would have been nice. I don't want to run back and forth right now, though. I think that'll just add time to the process. Then we got to decide what we want to use for a roof too. We definitely want some, like, adornments of some kind. We don't want it to just be a flat, like, square room with, like, one block making up all the walls. It's so boring. You need something, to break up the scene for your eyes. You need something to sort of partition up the room into digestible chunks that you're looking at. So, like, right now, let's just start by, like, we'll place... Let's say we wanted to go out this far. And then to here. You know what? I do want a tape measure. I think I already have a tape measure. And if you're not familiar with this, Bibliocraft adds a tape measure. And it's just a way you can mark blocks. So you can just see how many blocks different areas are. Let's get rid of this freaking random plants and shit here. Taking up all the inventory space. Is the eternal problem of modded Minecraft is inventory space is at such a premium all the time. Let's put the dirt away. There we go. Okay. This one has tools in it, so you have a tape measure. There we go. Boom. Okay. Let's take that out here. Oh, my back. My back is itchy. I'm sorry. It can't wait. You know how it is. So yeah, like this stuff. Maybe the rock crusher can go in here too. It depends how big the room is. Rock crusher could stay out there. But I mean, the rock crusher kind of belongs with the assembly table just because you use it to make machine frames. So all right, let's say we were here to here. So let's measure like this was inside. So put one there and right there. So that is 13 blocks of space. Should this project out a little further? I mean, this tree is right here. So this is only one block away from the tree. I'm just thinking, like, I mean, I guess it could come out a little further. Let's just, like, break this back here. Let's see what we're looking at. If we go back here... Oh, this was a, this was a, probably still is, a, magnetite vein, I believe. Yeah. I hear a real weird sound. I have never heard that sound before. You know, I'm not super inclined to figure out what the hell it is that makes that sound. I think I'm just going to nope the fuck out of here and not even figure it out. I don't care. You know what? You make that noise. You make that noise. It's your cave. You live in there. Whatever. I don't give a shit. So, okay. So, 13 blocks. I mean... I don't know. Assembly table is kind of big. Like, we're going to want it to be at least, like, probably 7 wide. Especially when you start making resonant machine frames. 7 by, like, 3. That's 21 lasers. Alright, so say we put another block over here. And this was our other wall. How wide is this? 11. I mean, that could be good. All right, let's chisel these up here. I'm not sure if I want this to go back any further, or even if I want this to come over. Well, we could have like a little back door that would come out into another region over here, because I do want this to be able to link up purely through the base and come out over by, you know where the farm is? I might as well show you. It'll help you get a better idea of what I'm talking about. So we'll just come up here real quick. And if we come up over here, it's kind of a ways, actually. But up over this hill is our farm area. I would like to have a doorway come in down there and have this whole thing covered by a glass dome. So that way we'd have a giant greenhouse. My ear is very itchy. It seems to be just wearing these headphones just makes my earlobes itchy. Not like the insides, just the outside. It's not gross. And even if it is, you're not actually sitting next to me. You're on the other side of the screen. It doesn't matter if it's gross. There you go. Totally justified. What the fuck am I even talking about? Anyhow. Yeah, this is my actual thought process. This is what I'm really thinking in real life all the time. So, okay. We have some choices here. We have regular brick and this brick. Let's try a little of both. I mean, it's a tough call. And then we can detail it with other kinds of marble. Or maybe we'll even detail it with some other blocks. Maybe we'll do like some dark oak trim. That could be nice. So let's pick up this. Boom. So I guess we'll do a room that's this size. It still feels like it might be a little small. Maybe. Let's lay some marble out here. So let's just, like, Let's not lose that like marker right there. And we can just use the chisel. It's just to switch them all en masse. You know, you can chisel blocks in the world with the diamond chisel, and you can do it like in a 3x3. If you don't like it, we'll just do that. So this is our Project Red marble brick. I'm not super feeling that. Okay, where does this go to? This is perfect. Right? This is perfect? This is perfect. Good. I hear that weird noise again, man. I feel like we're going to find out what the hell it is that makes that noise sooner rather than later, and it's going to be a real unpleasant encounter. Let's hope that that isn't what happens. Maybe we could do some fantasy blocks on here, like some chisel fantasy blocks. I always use those, though. I always end up using those, like the ones with the gold trim. Usually the white ones, not the purplish-hued ones. Like, every single time I build in any mod pack that has chisel, I always wind up using those. So at least for right now, I think I'd prefer to not use those. So these are our choices. Well, hey sweetie, what do you think? This or this? This?
Number one.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's kind of what I was thinking as well. I think I wholeheartedly agree with that. I've seen the other texture used, but I tend to shy away from it. There's only two options here. Like, all these other options are the same color as chisel marble, but switching it to Project Red marble, it's just the regular and the brick. Maybe we'll do something with this later. I don't know. You can use any of these other types of textures to mix them in, though, so it's way better. So what we can do now is we can just kind of like, bleh, put that on there, do panel, and just be like, bleh, 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 fixed. Good. Perfect. Okay. Now let's get these out of here. Give me these back, please. There we go. You're already chiseled. I think we need at least another set. And then we'll see what we can do for trim, maybe. That's my other thought. Maybe widen up the room a little bit to give it more room for, like, things inside. You know, like borders and, like, columns and stuff. Because those all cut into your overall working area. So we might want to make the room just a little bit bigger just to accommodate that. I think it's fine like this. I mean, I guess we could just knock this wall back a little further and, like, push this in some. Maybe, you know. Huh. Because this room is a little thin. I feel like it needs... And I can't knock this wall back any further. It needs to be about this long, just because of the fact that we got to have a corridor of some sort in here to separate the rooms. So yeah, this wall will kind of go back a little bit, and it'll just be cut into the hillside. So we'll knock this back at least two more. Let's sleep. Yeah, I think it'll be better if this room is a little bit wider. Plus, that way we'll have this little exit out back here into this opening. We'll be a little bit... It won't be hugging up against the wall, you know what I'm saying? Like, if we put a doorway here to make use of that little hole in the terrain, it'd have to be hugging right up against this wall. So if we move the wall back, we can put that doorway in a better spot. And I'm pretty sure we're going to wind up with a doorway there, and that is going to be part of what leads us back to the farm area eventually. Whoa, my god. Oh my, dude. Jeez, easy. Wow, that was loud. Okay. Buddy, you know, fucking always coming to fucking shit in my goddamn cornflakes, you know? Or Cheerios. I don't really like cornflakes. He shits in my Cheerios. Honey Nut Cheerios. Or even better, Apple Cinnamon Cheerios. I think Apple Cinnamon Cheerios are basically the king of Cheerios. Enter in the comments below. We're going to do that. But seriously, yeah, no, if you have a preference on your favorite type of Cheerios, I would like to know. That'd be kind of cool. I would definitely be interested in that. I think Apple Cinnamon's the best, or Honey Nut. I mean, I find it difficult to make the choice between those two. Ooh, free ender pearls. Can't complain about that. We're not really using ender pearls yet, but once we start, man, we will be pissing through them like mad. There's going to be gravel here, so let's just kind of do this. I'm just be like, fuck you, gravel. Okay? Tell that gravel to eat a fucking bowl of dicks. Yeah, how do you like that, gravel? Take that. That's what you get for being freaking gravel and annoying Minecrafters everywhere. So, put that there. I knew there was going to be a bunch of digging in this episode, because we did have to, like, sort of clear out this space to build this area. I didn't realize we'd be doing this much digging. This is a little extra. It's unfortunate, but oh well. It must be done. How's our inventory space doing? Oh, fucking terrible. What a shock. We'll use the bag if we need to. How high up is this? Because we need to be 6 high. Get out of here, gravel. Nobody likes you. Nobody. Does anyone like gravel? I mean, who plays Minecraft that's like, wow, gravel, what a great block. I really love the texture and how it, like, falls and tries to kill me and constantly gets in the way and slows down everything. Yeah, it's really fun. Oh, jeez. What, where? Who's where? Why is there a sound? I hear monsters. I should probably look at the map. The map will probably give me this information. Are you in here? You sneaky fucker. Yeah, yep. That's where you're at, huh? Dude, the knockback on those guys is fucking insane. Like, wow. How are they so strong? They're not even, like, the beefiest of the cyclopses. The brutes are. The ones that only show up at night. Those are by far the beefiest of the clopses. They don't have any weapons, though. I guess those guys are the only ones that have an actual weapon. They got those batons they fight with. So I suppose that would make them tougher. So, alright, we got this going on here. I'm going to knock out a little more of this here. I did prepare in advance in terms of picks, actually. We do have more picks. So, how high up is this? Boop, 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 boop. I got a bad feeling this is 5 blocks high here, probably. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, this is 5 blocks high. So, we're going to need to remove one more. We'll probably need to remove 2 more, actually, because we're going to need a roof. A roof is a thing we need. I got an interesting block I'd like to try for the roof, but we need clay. Oh, the fucking gravel, dude. Are you serious? Well, I mean, I guess that clears out some of the area that we need cleared. You know, that's something. Let's get this diorite out of here. I've been watching a lot of Iskal85 lately. I don't know if you guys have ever watched him. I like him. He's a Swedish guy. He's one of the hermits, actually. And he's pretty cool. He fucking hates diorite with a passion, though. Like, he has an irrational hatred of diorite. Let's get rid of some of this something here. I don't know. You and you. Get out of here. Cobbles, that, this. Yep, that guy out of there, too. Okay, great. Yeah, sure. Dirt, why not? Let's get that out of there. Oh, yeah, this, too. And the diorite. I kind of like diorite. It makes columns that are nice. Like, otherwise, you're going to use quartz to make columns. So, alright, let's start here. Put the block, there you go. And boom, 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 boom. Yeah, I'm still hearing that weird sound. Are you guys picking up on that too? I have never heard that sound before. I mean, that's not surprising. I've played this pack for, let's see, where is it? Stats? Statistics. We've been playing in this world for 4.82 days of my life. This current incarnation of the world. In the past, I've had other versions of this pack, but this current world, I've got a little over 100 hours. And I'm still hearing sounds I've never heard before. I don't even think I've seen half of the monsters that can exist. So we're at 4 here. This is 4 blocks high. We'll pick a trim after we just get the shape of the wall. Oh, you fucker. Why'd you do that? What was that all about? We gotta just chisel up these other blocks here. Alright, get the chisel. We gotta chis. Chis all over the place here. Chis this up. Chis that up real good. Yeah, chis. And chis. Okay, now please, use the correct blocks this time when you run out. That'd be great if you did that. And we got woofies. The woofies are a howling. I mean, that's fine. We can have that there too. As a matter of fact, what would this? Will this be 6? I think this will be 6 high right here. Do 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 do. Doot, doot, doot. And boop. Good. Boop, boop. And... whoops. I appear to have screwed up. Get back in there. Boop. There we go. Cool. And put this down here. And what else do we need? That looks like it's 6 high to me. I mean, we don't really come in the center of the room, but I mean, I guess that's okay. You don't need to come in the center of every room. I don't know if this wall needs to go back further, but either... You know, I think it's fine, actually. It gives us plenty of workable space. Alright, now we gotta kind of jump down here. Let's go down gently, so we do not hurt ourselves. Don't want to injure our legs during this important building operation. Gotta be concerned. Follow OSHA regulations here. Wanna build safe, you know? Use the skills we've learned from modern civilization so that we don't, you know, wind up with a lot of worker casualties, especially because I'm the only worker. Everybody wearing their hard hats? I think so. Yeah, this counts as a hard hat, right? Yeah, we're being safe. We're good. We get this under control. We are following proper workplace regulation for the modern world. We're doing good. Ah, why do you keep fucking doing that, dude? Like, I have more of the right block. Why do you keep doing that? It's bugs. It's a bug. It might be, actually. We don't have tons of marble left, which is a little concerning. This room is going to be quickly approaching its maximum size, which is why I've, you know, been building with cobblestone so much thus far, is that, like, I've just been concerned about availability. I think we're okay. We have a little bit more inside. This is going to be tricky. We're going to need to sort of dig this out. Kind of do it like a stairwell. Kind of. I hear the chocobos. I do love that sound. I'm so glad that ChocoCraft can now, like, be legitimately in the pack as opposed to just a recommended add-on. At first, I just had a really hard time getting a hold of the guy. I mean, he had no problems with me using it. It's just that he wasn't around to give the approval. And that was kind of troublesome. But he did eventually get back to me, so now it is a standard component of the pack. So there's only one thing that kind of belongs with the pack that can't be put in there, and that is, of course, Mo Creatures. I hope that you guys that are playing along at home did install Mo Creatures, because it is definitely a part of the experience, and it really does kind of belong with things. I don't know why the guy freaking hates mod packs and pack makers so goddamn much. Maybe he's allergic to success. I don't know. I think it's more that he just kind of wants to hold everybody hostage. If people pay him enough on Patreon, he will allow Mo Creatures to be used in mod packs just ubiquitously, which is, you know, kind of bullshit. Kind of goes against the whole spirit of modding and, like, the community. You're not supposed to be able to charge for that, dude. This is Mojang's game. You can't charge to do things like that. And it's on real dubious terms in the EULA, but either way, he's getting away with it. I'm not pleased with his decisions, but it's his property, and I can't make up his mind for him. What do we think? Is this big enough? Ow. And also, we're going to need some sort of a door here. How wide is this? 1, 2, 3... I got the fucking tape measure. Why am I counting? Let's just kind of put this here. No, what are you doing? Put that. Good. There you go. So this is from here to here. What do we got? That is 11, so this is going to be a single door that goes out. Unless we change the shape of this some and knock a wall back. Do I want it to be a double door? I mean, I don't mind that this is a single door. I like this being a single door. If there was a way out back here, I would also want that to be a single door. So if we're going to do a... You know... Let's find the center here. That'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's 6. This is the center. So then we would knock this out. Oh, come on. Oh, sleepy time. Sleepy time. Fresh pick. Boom. Now, obviously, we're not just going to have the single door just, like, floating here like this. We'll have some sort of structure around to bring attention to it. Let's back it up some. See how this looks with the door there. We need to get rid of this shit in front of the building here, I think. This does not look good. Maybe before I commit to removing this dirt, though. Yeah, this is going to look off-center. No matter what I do, I think it's going to look off-center. Unless we could just trim it back a little bit. So maybe it doesn't extend this far out, but we do have a little bit of dirt in front of it. So we'll just take off the top layer here. Yeah, this is still in the way. Maybe we want some of that back. We don't need the axe for this right now. Ooh, got a little bit of lag there from the backup. So, oh my, Scrubby. Hi, how you doing? These guys are dangerous as fuck. So, we want to be careful. Oh, he's got buffs. He's got buffs, dude. I don't think I want to fuck with that, man. I don't want to mess with Scrubby with buffs. It really does skew. I don't trust you back there, man. I got my eye on you. Don't be a dick. Oh shit, he's being a dick. Oh shit, he's being a dick. Ah, am I in? Am I out? Am I in? I'm out. I'm out. We don't want to be out. We want to be in. Ugh. Okay, that was real fucking sloppy. What happened? At speed. That's the buff he's got. See how fast he moved? Where the balls did he go? So yeah, before I got scared away, I was definitely thinking that having any dirt in front of that looks unbalanced. Maybe we should just... Oh, Jesus Christ, what the fuck was that? Oh, it was a charger. A charger just jumped off the edge. So, cat, what are you doing? Easy. Kitty. Chill. Oh yeah, okay, there's another charger. He's out here. Okay, get the fuck out of here. There's the Scrubby. I want that XP. I want it. I kind of need to kill this guy, too. Yep, uh-huh, yep, you made a sound. Okay, put this here. Let's go make a door of some kind and put the door on, because we need a door there. No matter what, we're going to want a door there, obviously. And we're going to want some kind of trim around the outside, something to break up the white. We can't have that be a white block either, because that, like, it's too much. I don't know that we even want to use any more marble. How much more marble do we have? So we have blah, blah, blah. This is Greg Tech Marble. This does not count. This, you can't chisel this into anything. It's a cobble and regular, and that is it. So we have 2 stacks and 8 plus. So we have like 3 2/3 stacks of marble left, which is not a lot. Like, we blew through many a stack of that. Let's chisel this back. And maybe we'll grab the stuff that we don't need and throw it away into storage here. So let's get our cobble, grab that, grab these, grab this. And let's just, you know, let's take a moment to get ourselves sorted here. And then we're going to make some decisions about what other blocks to use. I feel like we want some kind of a dark wood to accompany this. I think that would add a nice accent to it. I mean... There's a lot of good colors of clay, but we don't have access to a lot of clay. I think we need to build a clay generator in the near future. Something that can exploit that clayconia and maybe, like, a pulverizer, so you could just dump cobble into it. Maybe you could even have a cobble generator on it, and then it would literally just make clay. Actually, as maybe more of a generalized thing, we need a cobble works. That's definitely... something that's got to come up in the near future is we could use a cobble works pretty badly just to make cobble, stone, sand, glass, clay. That's a thing we could make. Other things, silicon is probably a thing we could make. That would be good if we made that. That's a thing. There's other stuff. I'm like reaching around in my head trying to think of other things. Is the gravel thing full? Is that what's going on here? I don't believe you're full. You are not full. Give me this. Put this the frick away. Also, having the drawers up here, not really great, you know? It's not working out for me. So, alright, we need a door. Let's look what we got for doors here. We have carpenter's doors also. So if we don't find anything we see like right off the bat here that's good, we can screw around with carpenter's doors, and then you can have whatever you want. But that's... I don't know. Not sure about that. So that's a carpenter's door. All of these are extra trees. These are all forestry doors, so we don't really have any of that going on. Bloodwood, that's Natura. Do we have any Sakura trees, actually? Just as kind of a side... Oh, we do. We have two of them. We need to grow these. I love these trees. They're really nice-looking trees. I just want these on our property. These are darkwood trees. This is like an Ars Magica door. My mind is just wandering all over the place. I know. You're hearing my rambling here. Like, what is he talking about? He's talking about, like, six different things. I know. It's the ADD. I can't help it. So, I mean, for regular doors here... Spruce, blah, 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 blah. What's next? What else do we got? So these are Malice's doors here. So this thing is huge. Medieval door. How do I make you? I don't. Okay. Gotcha. Force field. Acacia door. It's a birch door. Dark oak door. Looks promising. That's the jungle door. This is the spruce door. Spruce door or dark oak door both look promising. Wooden glass door, iron glass door. It's kind of nice. I mean, laboratory door. We have one of those already. We're going to use that for... give me that, actually. I want one of those. Where did I put it? This is going to go right on the hallway here. What do we think? Let's get the dark oak. Let's see what we got for dark oak here. We don't have a lot. So we're going to turn you into planks, probably, and you will be remaining whole. I took two full stacks, right? Yeah, let's go to the saw. Now, right here... Oh, I didn't fill this in yet. This is where the laboratory door is going to go. Let's get some cobblestone here. And chisel up some cobblestone. I don't have any on me, right? Okay, cool. Grab that. Did you grab it? Oh yeah, the sound just went stupid on me again. Lovely. You know, it never happens when I'm playing single player. Oh, there it's back. We're fine again. Lovely. I don't know why that happens. It only seems to happen when I'm using the headset. So like right here, let's just kind of like build this out up somehow. Oh yeah, because this is in the way. Uh-huh, I see. Yeah, you're in the way. Well, we'll break this out, and then we'll put the door in place, and then we can walk around the door right now, but where's that going to go? Like that? Yeah, that'll be good. So, yeah, let's put the glass pane away. Just one last thing in my inventory. I'm kind of thinking to myself right now. I know it seems like I'm just dicking around, but I do, actually, the wheels are in motion right now. Just trying to think of what to do next. Now, obviously, we have been going for a little bit here, so probably won't get through this entire room here, but let's try and make some more decisions about it. This is like a witch up there. That's a coven witch. Otherwise, she'd be, like, fucking wrecking our faces by now. I need a crafting table. I don't want to waste... I didn't make planks, and I don't want to waste dark oak on a crafting table, because we have so little of it. I do have the, what's it face, the watering can, so I can watering can or even bone meal up saplings now. Wow, that depletes the thing so fast. Depletes it so fast. A dark oak door. I only get one. Sometimes you get three doors for some recipes. Other times you get one. I mean, I feel like vanilla is supposed to be one. I don't know why sometimes you get three doors. I'm not really sure what made that change. It's weird. I don't know. It's not really a big deal, so I haven't really tracked it down. It's not like it's severely unbalanced or anything. The mobs. There are mobs. They're, like, in there, according to the map. They're, like, up on there. Okay, so let's put this right here. So next we'll want some kind of an overhang, maybe? Let's, round this out a little bit here. Let's put some grass right there. Some, like, right there. I heard a terrible sound. Oh, there he is. It's Scrubby. He's right over there. Close this off for a sec. Get sleep. Maybe that's what's been making that noise all along. Maybe it's that guy. So, I kind of need a crafting table out here, just in case I want to make some, like, stairs or something. I don't know if these are the blocks I'm going to settle on. I kind of like to have like an overhang, like a porch, if you will, on the front of it. I don't know that I want to do the whole thing out of dark oak. I do want oak, like, columns holding it up. Let's just get a little bit of regular wood here and make a crafting table real quick. Yeah, cool. Whip this up. Just like this. Let's do that. And we'll just plop that down out there as we try and figure out what it is that we want to do with this here. And then we want to do some like detailing in here too. Let's just throw this down in the middle so it's not like in our way. Let's put that right there. Also the chisel. I really wish I brought a little bit more marble on me so I could chisel marble blocks. So let's just, let's get rid of this asshole here. He's really kind of concerning me. Yeah, it's him. He's been making that noise all this time. Ow! Oh, you make fire. Okay, well, we gotta fight you in the water then, huh? Or the liquid essence. He wasn't so bad. I mean, he's bad. I wouldn't want to run into that guy when I'm out exploring, but still, not, like, horrible. Oh, we want some windows, too. We'll definitely want windows. Get this out of here. So, like, let's say, like, right here, we threw down some oak logs just to kind of like build this up. Three. And then right here. Yeah, that's like right here. So right here and right here. Just like this. One, two, three. I mean, let's just start making a shape here. You know, let's just make the basic shape. Now, we're going to want this angled a little bit. So it's five across for that. Now, we definitely want that to, like, hang out some as well. There is a bit of a texture difference between the logs and this. Let's make some stairs. You know, even if this just makes the basic shape that we want, and we gotta swap out the blocks, and at least that's something. It'll give us an idea of what we're working with here. You know what? Make all of them. Yeah, we got dirt. I like that colored door. That colored door is definitely working for me. This beehive is just kind of in the way here. So let's do it like this. Actually, it's right over here. You know what would be great? Flight. Flight would be pretty great right now. You know? Fuck you. Alright. I need the axe. Yeah, need the axe. So, put this there. Good. No. No. I'll do that. Get out of here. Okay. Oop. Let's see. Yeah, you want to click on the bottom half of the block. You know, why? What would make you think I would have wanted it there, game? The fuck? So, okay, we got that going on. I feel like I want something redder than this. Like, color-wise. Oh, what did we get? We got a hot shot. Sets enemies on fire, 9 range damage, slow speed. If already on fire, deals double damage. This is actually kind of usable. We make pellets out of limonite. The common limonite, not the Gregtech limonite. So that is that. I mean, I'm not really a fan. I feel like it's too big, too. I'm not really feeling this. I mean, maybe it's just the oak logs. Maybe it needs to not be so big. Yeah, maybe, like, logs are wrong. Maybe we just want detailing, like, right around the door. Maybe this is too much overhang, is what I'm getting the feeling of. So let's break this down, and we'll try something else. I'm not a good builder, right? I will admit it. I don't really have, you know, the best aesthetic sense in the world. I have a fairly shitty one, in fact. But I'm trying. You know, I don't want to live in a direwolf 9x9. That's not okay with me. I want it to look good. So I watch a lot of other YouTubers, like Wells Knight, and especially... Wells Knight's amazing in his own right, as is, like, Iskall85. They're both just phenomenal builders. And Hypnotized, he builds some cool stuff, too. I mean, all the Hermits generally build cool stuff. Etho's my favorite, just because I really like Etho. Like, I like listening to him, and he builds really cool-looking things. So, I mean, we could do like that, and then maybe like this. Just a small overhang around this. You know, why? What the fuck? Why would I want that there? That's retarded. Ugh. Come the fuck on, game. Do that, and come over here at that, and there. I mean, it's certainly better than before. I still kind of like it to be redder. Break this shit down. Let's take a look at this. It cuts into our space for windows like that as well. That is also not good. I mean... Huh. Let's think about what we can do for in here, and then I think I'm going to have to call the episode, because we have been doing this for quite a bit of time now. Let's see what we can do for trim. I mean, we can go with a different marble block, or we can do patterns of marble block. Let's make some chisel blocks. We need to despawn him! What the fucking balls! Okay. So, if you didn't know, that's an ogre. When they get angry, they break blocks. Lots of them, en masse. So, he can easily just destroy everything. He can just reset our entire progress. He can send us back to the beginning of the fucking game. Like, 5 days worth of work ago. So, you know what? Let's just nope the fuck out of there. I don't know how he spawned inside, but it doesn't surprise me that there's enough dark spots for him to spawn. That is crazy bad luck. Also, I feel like I need to look into the spawning rules, because I feel like they're maybe not being respected. That things are spawning when there should be enough light to keep them at bay. I'm just not sure. It certainly seems like it some of the time, though. So we now need to just nope the fuck out of here. We can't go home because of that. So I guess we'll kind of keep recording here. Here's a pylon. It's a black one. That's freaking useless. It's not one of the colors I don't have. So let's just get far enough away so that everything despawns. We just need to despawn everything. We'll go out of range. I think it's like 128 blocks or something. And then anything that was spawned will be forcibly despawned. And then we're okay. That's not what you want to see. Oh, hey, let's make this mission worthwhile. Seriously? We'll get some basalt. I don't know if we're going to use basalt for what we're building right now, but basalt is a really nice block. I like it. You know, it's an easy color to use. It's dark. We could end up encountering blazes here, like in the overworld, which is not something I really want. What is making that? A fucking fuck you, snake! What the hell is that? Fuck you, dude! It's a rattlesnake. Not really all that poison. I've got a couple eel canes over there that I don't really want to deal with either. The snakes don't usually attack. I mean, I've had them kind of, like, get pissy at me, but, like, I've never had them attack. This turns to cobble. This turns into a cobble. Interesting. I didn't know that it turned to a cobble. Kind of slow. I want a lot of it. Like, tons. This is a great block to build with. It's really easy. I think it's chiselable. I have my chisel. Let's try and chisel it. Okay, it's not chiselable in that form anyway. Or maybe I've just been watching too much 110, where the basalt from, I think, actually additions is chiselable. Either way, it's still a nice block, but I think that there's something you can do with it. I feel like if you smelt this back down, it is chiselable. I didn't realize it made a cobblestone form, though. So yeah, now you're just watching me mine cobblestone. That's a thing. You got to stick with the uninteresting parts, though, for the craziness, which hopefully didn't happen. I really hope that ogre did not, like, break anything. Because otherwise, we're just going to be reverting back to dumps, because, like, what the fuck is that? What is following me now? What is pissed? Oh, bone back. Great. Uh-huh. Okay, buddy. Chill. Wow, you have a lot of health. My back is literally against the wall. Okay. Run away. Yeah, I don't need a pylon fucking shooting at me right now. That'd be great to not have that, if possible. Do those guys like swimming? I really hope the answer is no. Fuck it. What we need to do right now, like right now, is go like this. Just like that. Boom. Okay, we're in a tree. That's good. We want to be in a tree. That is where we were trying to go, was up into a tree. There we go. Safe. Did you see that glowy ball? I believe that was ball lightning. I don't know what it does. I know it's from Chromatocraft. That's about it. It comes out of pylons, I guess. I think that's what it is, anyway. Or it could just be some random sparkly dew that is not called ball lightning. That could be the case as well. Okay, having a kind of a rough end of the episode here. Let's get back to base. I have 56 basalt, but I mean, I know where the basalt is. I'll go get more off camera. So, Boneback can still kick the fucking shit out of us in, like, two or three hits. We completely lack the capacity to be able to tank hits from those guys. That is not something we can do. There's so many of these little freaking fish here, dude. Get the fuck out of here. There's too many of you. Actually, they're on a different mob. I was gonna say, like, they should be, they're impeding the spawning of other creatures, but they're not. They're water creatures. So there's five or six categories? Maybe there's only five. There's creatures, which are, you know, non-hostile mobs. Monsters, which are hostile mobs. Ambients, like bats and bugs and stuff. Water creatures, which are those things. Water monsters, which are monsters, but underwater. So like squids, fishies, those are water creatures. Water monsters would be like any of the hostile Lycanites things. And then there's the underground category for anything that can't spawn above Y level 45. Are we cool? Are we cool? Oh, thank God we're cool. Okay, alright, cool. Where could he have spawned? I mean, this spot right here is kind of dark. He could have spawned right here. I don't know how dark this is. I don't know, this feels like this is bright enough. Not real sure how that possibly happened. I don't know. It's something I gotta look into. It's problematic. But thank you guys so much for watching. I know it's kind of a different sort of episode. We tried to like build something and honestly didn't really get all that far. Talked about, you know, random stuff. That's always fun too. I like to talk to you guys. That's part of the fun of Let's Playing, is just having a conversation and starting conversations with the audience. It's really cool. Next time we will probably be back on to progress. I'm going to continue working on this stuff off camera until I get something that doesn't look, you know, terrible. If it looks passable, I'll call it good. I'm not really amazing builder. I don't have an excellent aesthetic sense. You know, like, I can program a website for you, but making it look good, you need to tell me what you want it to look like. Otherwise, it's going to be trouble. Just, you know, you need to tell me what you want. That's my specialty, really, is I make the code. I can't make it look nice. So I'm working on that, though. I'm trying to exercise those artistic skills by just, like, picking out color pattern, like color palettes and textures and trying to make things that work. You know, it's to fill in a certain weakness, you know, and not on a lot of artistic skills, and I'd like to improve that. And this is something I can do to practice that. So that's cool. So I will continue practicing that, and if you're enjoying the series, then please drop a like. It would help me and the channel out tremendously. And if you're enjoying the series, then you can hit that little red subscribe button, and you'll be notified of whenever I release more content, and that would be great. So once again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Peace.